international versus traditional athletics. Growing up, Sean and I have always been a part of sports. We participated in a number, including swimming, judo, American football, and basketball. But now as we transition into high school, we have to begin to balance school with
sports. And this led us to the major question of which type of school would best help us develop as athletes, international or traditional schools?
Due to my experience with international schools, and due to Nick's experience with traditional schools, I'll be taking the international side, and you'll be taking the traditional side. I moved from Israel when I was 6.5 years old, which gives me almost 9 years of experience in an international community, while Nick moved from 3 years ago from a traditional into an international community.
Next, we'd like to discuss how the sports work in each type of school. And before we go too much further, I'd like to discuss that for the international schools, we're going to be using our school, AAS, as an example, and for the traditional schools, we're going to be taking the American school system in for that.
Our school is a part of an organization called CESA. CESA stands for Central Eastern European School Association. CESA gives an opportunity for people to create different events, like sporting events, like basketball, volleyball, or different events like robotics or math jams. CESA has this thing called hosting. Hosting is when you have a family that has children in the school, that are participating in the school, take you in for a few days and treat you like family. This is considered better than a hotel because this gives you the cultural aspect of the whole travel and you get to make new friends and enjoy your travels.
Traditional schools are quite different. First of all, the sporting events are held mainly once or more per week, and this differs a lot from international schools because generally we have, in our school for example, maybe a couple games throughout the season, for example basketball, and then we lead up to one big event, and I think this is just a big benefit towards the school. Next we have, I guess, a higher team chemistry because the people grow up together throughout their life, and this can be the same in international schools, but a lot of people come and go. Next, you have much more practices per season, and this just cannot be avoided in international schools. So this led us to the next question of which one is better for the development of athletes. We'll weigh out the pros and cons of each and discuss.
To begin with the pros for international schools, one of them is being cultural inclination. What this means is that international school is made up of hundreds and hundreds of different students from different cultures. This helps you learn about their culture, understand how unique your culture is, and also make new friends, which leads us to my next point. New friends. As you know, in international school, people come and go all the time, which also helps you make new friends almost every single year. Travel. As I've said before, CESA is a great opportunity for you to travel while playing your favorite sport or participating in your favorite event with with other students, friends, and you just get a chance to travel around the world and discover new things. Last is connection with the coaches. Unlike traditional schools, most of the coaches in international schools are teachers. This is important because as you go through the season with your coach, you get to know them better, you get to create better chemistry with them, and make a great connection that will help you out throughout the year. This is important because if you ever have troubles or need some help, your coach or teacher is always there to help you.
Traditional schools are different. First of all, you have deeper roots with your teammates. This can be seen through growing up with the same people in your community. For example, in America, I'm a part of a swim team called the Victory Lakes Piranhas. And every year I go back and I make new bonds, stronger bonds with my teammates, and this declares more of a family atmosphere than you would a team atmosphere. Next is the cost, and this just allows, I guess, less income families to send their kids to school and give them the opportunity to compete in sports, opposed to our school, or international schools in general, which are just much more expensive to send the kids to school. Next is the atmosphere of the school. This is because the team's location of the games is much closer to the people's homes, so they can come to the games more, the stadiums are much more filled, and they have more team spirit and atmosphere because you have a lot of people wearing the colors of the games and expressing their, I guess, pride towards their team against the others. Next is the location, and this ties into the atmosphere because the schools are public and not private schools, so they're in a much more open area in the middle of neighborhoods and complexes, which allows the kids to come and go from school easier, and this is much easier for the athletes to get to and from. Lastly, this can more trainings. This cannot be avoided in international schools, but it is a big problem because in the American school system, we have 5 practices or more a week, which are very long, 2-hour practices, opposed to the international schools, which cannot avoid it. For example, our school, which we share middle school and high school practices, so we need to share the facilities between both, opposed to the American school system, the traditional schools, where we have 2 different sections for the middle and high school, so they're 2 completely different buildings, so they have their own facilities. Next are the cons.
A few cons for international schools are 1, being isolated from local life. Imagine a bubble. You're a new student and you come to international school and you're stuck in that bubble. All you do is go to school, come back home, and you have no idea what's going on all around you. All you know is a few friends from school, your school, and homework. Me being outside of that bubble for almost 7-8 years now, I've been participating in different sport teams like basketball and judo for 7 to 8 years now. I understand how local life works, and I've been going out more often, which helps me understand how it works. Unlike international new students from international schools, they don't understand the language, and it's harder for them to learn, which is way harder for them to go out and understand how the local life works. People come and go. As I said before, in international schools, people come and go all the time. This is a this is the big flaw in sports team, because almost every year, you have a new team. You have to rebuild your chemistry, rebuild your connection, and it's just not the family part that you have from traditional schools. Next is cost. As we all know, international schools, being private, are very expensive, and many not very fortunate families can't really afford it, unlike more fortunate families. Last con is language. If you come from a country that doesn't speak English and you come to international schools, it'll be very tough for you to learn English. English is important, not English. Language is important for you in the school because, 1, it helps you communicate with the team during practices and without practices. It helps you learn the language, helps you learn in the school, and it just all connects to the team and how you can communicate with other people. Plus, while learning the language, it adds on to all the work you already have. As middle school and high school students, we know that the workload gets more and more, and adding learning a language, that is an extra work that is just too heavy for us to do.
In traditional schools, one of the major cons is the fact that you have a reduced amount of cultural interaction. Although this is very obvious in these schools, it goes much deeper than you may think, and this is the fact by, for example, before I moved to Bulgaria, I had a lot of different ideas about other cultures and people. They weren't necessarily bad, but they were just, I guess, different, and they were proven wrong as I moved here. And for sports teams, I guess I could see that, and I would stop talking certain ways about groups of people. Next is you have less opportunity to engage in new friends. So this is opposite from the fact that people do come and go, but this is also bad because if you get mixed with a bad apple in your class, you don't like him, you're stuck with him. So you have to grow up with him, you just have to deal with it. And also when you're a new student going to these schools, you're sort of trapped in another metaphorical bubble because I guess nobody else sort of wants to take you in some of the times, and it's hard for you to engage in new friendships.
In conclusion, we have decided that traditional schools are better to build up the athletic part of the student athlete. This is due to 3 major points that me and Nick have made.
The first one would be the cost, and this just allows, as we said, the less fortunate families to come and participate in sports. Because you could be an amazing athlete and come from a lower income family and never have the opportunity to engage yourself in sports just because of where your parents came from. Next is the atmosphere and the fact that you have deeper roots dug in with your friends. And this just helps the overall atmosphere of the school because it's more of a family-based relationship. Although in international schools, they tend to be smaller, so this is also the case because we have more of a family-connected base. But opposing this, the traditional schools, you grow up with the same people over the whole course of your life and not just within high school or middle school. The last would be the practices. And again, I'll emphasize that international schools cannot avoid this because we do share the facilities between middle and high school. So we have to split up the practices. But within traditional schools, they allow more practices per week, which help in developing yourself.